Tamara Broadbent. I'm doing my debut solo show every day in the underbelly at 4:45. It's called Almost Epic and it's about my quest to become a serious professional rock star artist. And this is a little taster. So yeah, I'll start by introducing myself. I normally get a bit kind of nervous at points like this and don't know exactly what to say. So I did the logical, sensible thing and I composed this gangster rap about my childhood, which I'm going to do for you now. It goes a little something like this. Once upon a time, there was a little girl, and she had dreams of being on the big stage. And she wanted to fly all over the world and see her face on every front page. When she was young, she joined lots of Amdram drama groups, but was never really part of them stage school troops. She was unique and she practiced her piano every day of the week. When the other kids were out and about and the bros were finding their hoes, yeah, she was home on her own going over her scales and arpeggios, yeah. On the whole, she embraced the role of the frizzy-haired keyboard player. But she knew she'd rather be someone on TV like Buffy the Vampire Slayer. So she slaved for years, there was blood, sweat and tears, and she never gave up until the dream came true and the call came through when she got a very small part on the bill, yeah. Oh, there was a little girl, and she had dreams of being on the big stage. When she wrote her first song, she wondered why she hadn't been doing this all along. And even though she was small, she headlined a 50-seater gig at the local village hall. She was the town team pop star, planned to be a pop star, thought she'd be as big as Coca-Cola. Till someone wiser and older told her, your lyrics are as cheesy as Gorgonzola. She was hurt, but she didn't give up. She took on board the advice. And knowing she would have to toughen up, and understanding the price, that she'd have to stop being one of the nerds, and then go, go, go like Thunderbirds, to become a full-blown badass. She's not a corma now, she's a chicken mad rats. Oh, there was a little girl, and she had dreams of being on the big stage. Break it down! If she was famous, everyone would know her name. But she's not, so they don't. Not being famous is lame. When I if she was famous, she'd be getting a lot more calls. But she's not, so she isn't. Not being famous sucks balls. Here we go now, how's she doing now? It's hard to tell, somewhere between average and moderately well. But I remember that little girl's dream, and I know like a salmon she is swimming upstream. If there's a pool of opportunity, she's in like an Olympic diver. But she won't throw a strop if she does a belly flop. Like Beyonce, she is a survivor. If you've lost her, check in Costa, she'll have a cappuccino, or she'll be at home on the vino, suffering from malnutrition, cursing a bad audition. She puts the girl in singer, she's fierce, got more balls than Andy Murray. She's the baddest, toughest, fiercest chick that ever was born in Surrey. And cut.
Hi, welcome back to Waffle TV, sponsored by Westphere. I'm Daisy Savage, and today I'm here with Tamara Broadbent.
Hello.
How are you?
Good, thanks. Really, really good.
Good.
That's fun. And tell us a bit about your show. So it's a musical comedy show. It's about my quest to become a serious professional rock star artist and write an epic rock hit. And yeah, it's like lots of story songs and experiences from being a good girl gone bad to having an aging rocker as a dad and yeah, all that kind of stuff. So it's really cool. Lots of audience participation, like lots of fun.
Yeah. And how long have you been singing and writing songs?
Ages. it feels like ages. So I've been playing the piano since I was like 5, writing songs since I was about 13, and just doing all kinds of various genres. Like I do, started in like pop songs, I've done a drum and bass song, I've done I write musicals as well, so I've written about 2 musicals that I'm working on.
Wow, then, great.
Yeah, I do kind of like standalone cabaret numbers, and then this all kind of led to writing this. So,
great. And so, what made you wanted to combine comedy with your music? Is that just your personality shining through?
I suppose it just happened, yeah. It was just kind of, I'm a lyricist, I think, primarily.
Yeah.
And, yeah, just as I was writing the stories, I think of myself as like a musical storyteller. And I have a lot of like quite funny stories to tell, I guess. And just doing that in a way that I can, like the best way I can, through the songs.
Great. Yeah. What do you think of Fringe so far?
Oh, I'm loving it. Yeah.
Is that your first time here? You've been before?
I've been once. But only with a play, I haven't been here to do my own stuff at all, so
Great. Yeah,
it's the first time.
And do you think you'll be back again?
Oh, definitely. Yeah. I don't think I'll ever not be able to come because of how good it is.
Great, well thanks so much for talking to us today.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
And if you'd like to see it, it's at 4:45 Underbelly Cowgate. Thank you so much.
Thanks for having me.